Hello and good day. Did you know that the incidence of chronic kidney disease has increased significantly over the past decade? And did you know as a result of this, the incidence of people needing to be on dialysis have increased and needing to get a kidney transplant has increased? And did you know that this video, this particular video, may be the video that may protect your kidneys, save your kidneys, and prevent and protect you from moving on into dialysis if you have kidney disease? I am Dr. Rafai. I am the virtual nephrologist, and I wanted to talk to you today briefly about screening for kidney disease. Screening has been proven through many disciplines in medicine to be the most effective preventive measure that can early detect and make a difference. And screening for kidney disease is no different than other screenings. The only advantage of screening for kidney disease, it's a simple test. It's a blood test and a urine test. A simple urine test. Whereas when you're talking about colonoscopy, it could be cumbersome, could be uncomfortable, and may have some risk. If you're talking about mammography, is inconvenient and a little bit uncomfortable. Same with a prostate exam. So in reality, screening for kidney disease is simple and it's fairly inexpensive. So do not talk yourself into saying prohibitively expensive. I do not have means to go to the doctor or to the healthcare provider, so I cannot screen myself for kidney disease. It is fairly easy. And the reason it is important, because if we early detect whether you have kidney disease or not, we can make a difference for you. We can reduce the rate of progression. We can protect the kidneys from any further damage. We can institute strategies to help you reduce the risk of your kidney disease. And if your kidney disease advances to the point that it's getting pre-dialysis, we can reduce the risk of complications and have a soft landing, so to speak, into that world. So, should you get a screening for kidney disease, I would encourage you to definitely pursue screening if you have diabetes, if you have high blood pressure, if you have a risk in your family, if you have obesity, if you smoke, if you're over the age of 60 or had a heart attack or a stroke in the past. Definitely you need to be screened for kidney disease to see if you have kidney disease. And the tests are fairly simple. A simple, inexpensive blood test called creatinine, and you can measure the percentage of kidney function or the GFR or EGFR. And a urine test, which is also even simpler test, and you can tell whether there's protein in the urine. And to be even more precise, we can check for microalbumin, which can detect even small, minute amount of protein in the urine. This is fairly an easy test, both the blood and the urine, and give tremendous amount of information for prevention of further progression and institution of methods and strategies to reduce the risk of progression of kidney disease. Now, over the past year and a half, everybody was talking about COVID, and I'm talking about COVID as well today, but we have noticed that people will have some form of kidney damage when they get COVID, or they have accelerated progression of kidney disease. So it behooves you not only for general information, but now it is more urgency and more pressure than before to know whether you have kidney disease or not. So with this, I hope I have been able to make the case that you owe it to yourself, you owe it to yourself to tell yourself yes or no whether you have kidney disease or not, and to visit your provider if there is kidney disease to seek professional help for further prevention of any additional damage or even reversal of kidney disease. With this, I love you all. Stay healthy and safe. I am Dr. Rafai, the virtual nephrologist.